Are you looking to find your ideal lifestyle? At Metropolitan Living Realty Group, we are the premier realty group who put you first. Our boutique real estate firm is comprised of an elite team of experienced, knowledgeable, and dedicated real estate professionals focused on your success. With our unique blend of cutting-edge thinking and highly personal real estate representation, we simply enjoy assisting our clients find their ideal lifestyle through home ownership. Contact us today.
What's up, DMV? The lockdown is over. Are y'all ready to celebrate? Yeah. Well, who you gonna go with? DJ Rick. That's right. Call DJ Rick at 202-749-7903 or email him djrick4321@gmail.com and let DJ Rick handle all the sound at your next event. DJ Rick. Any size, any location. Barbecues, weddings, graduations, live bands. Mo, I'm telling you, DJ Rick combines the professional sound system with the best music selection in the whole DMV. Guaranteed. And all that for a price you're not going to beat. Call DJ Rick Entertainment, 202-749-7903. Or email him, djrick4321@gmail.com. That's 202-749-7903 and djrick4321@gmail.com. And make your next event sound like your best event. DJ Rick Entertainment. Who else you going to go with?
Hey, what's up? It's been a long time, but they done put me back in the game for one night only, and I am ready. Yep, Party Mode Live, Wednesday night, 8 o'clock on all social media platforms. We're going to get it in, man. It's going to be an uptown party. We got a lot of information to share with you, and I got a lot of crank built up. So make sure you catch us, Party Mode Live, the party before the party. It's going down. Yes, sir.
Alright, so what's up, what's happening? It's me, your man, DJ Dirty Rico from Washington, D.C. Representing the DMV. Oh, can I tell you, ain't nothing but a party, baby. All the noise being made on Party Mode Live. Stop playing, fix your face, and get out the way.
Get it.
Was a student of the game, then I became the teacher. Miss, we fell out a while ago, and now it's hard to reach her. It's not the heart to please her, it's all in how you treat her. My name is Risa, the daughter of a preacher. Was a student of the game, then I became the teacher. Miss, we fell out a while ago, and now it's hard to reach her. It's not the heart to please her, it's all in how you treat her. We living life you've been anyway, and honestly, you're overpriced. Your own eyes. I'm living life. Hey. You've been in the way, and honestly, you're overpriced. Hey. Hi, hi. Hey. Put you on the back burner, put your own eyes.
Where y'all from?
My rights, I'm writing my wrongs. Could book me a dude, could book me a bra. Ain't breaking my mind, I love and that's fine. What's
brain caught you, like you pay my dues. Shit, that's boo-boo the fool. Can choose who you love, universe, choose it cool. I'm living life, living life. And honestly, honestly, love you overpriced.
You already know, man. You already know what time it is, right? This is No Mirage. It's me, your man, DJ D-Money, and I am back in the saddle to get down with my team. Always in the heart. It's time for Party Mode Live, and we are getting ready to do it like no other can. It's an uptown show. We got it going down tonight. You hear me? So make sure you tell a friend to tell a friend, share this and all that and some. So I'm trying to find out. You know what I'm saying? I don't do this by myself. I don't do this by myself. Is Justice J in the background ready to pop up or nah? There she is, the first lady of Party Mode Live. What's up, baby girl?
What's up, sir?
That's what's up, man. I am so excited, as you can tell. It's good to be on this side of the screen this time. We're going to have some fun tonight. Hey, but there's another third of this party that keeps it going, that tells it like it is.
I have to give him his praise.
Where's my man, Bishop King? Well, I guess it's just me and you, Justice. Okay. It's okay. We'll do it.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Can you hear me? Okay. I'm just making sure.
Yes, I can hear you.
But yeah, Bishop won't be here for a couple more minutes, so he'll be on soon.
Okay, okay. So what's going on? What we got popping tonight? This is your ship. I'm just a hand in the vessel. And shout out to my man Rick.
We have a great show for everybody tonight. Welcome you guys to Party Mode Live. We have a lot of people coming on today to talk about this Saturday, the biggest event of the year that we've been talking about forever. So Emory Heights Community Day is happening this Saturday, y'all. And we have a couple of people that are coming on tonight to talk about what they're doing and what they're contributing to this community day. So we have, of course, DJ D-Money, who is our special guest DJ of the night, because he is Party Mode family. So he's no stranger to us. But then we also have C3W, the wrestling. The wrestlers who are going to be doing live wrestling on Saturday. They're coming on tonight to talk about that. Then we also have Miss Danny Danette Tucker of GoGo Fitness. And then we have Pump Blenders. And we also have Miss Janeese Lewis George, who is going to be, I believe she's a council member, and she's going to be talking to us about the giveaway and the community event as a whole. So, y'all, we have an action-packed interview show for y'all tonight. So, I'm really excited. DJ D Money is with us tonight. So, I have not been on the show with him in a long time. So, we're going to have fun. I got the sound effects, and yeah, we got it. DJ Rick. And Bishop King is on the way. DJ Rick cannot be with us tonight, y'all. So make sure, like I said, it always keep him in your prayers because life be lifing. So we're going to let DJ D Money rock out for a few minutes. And then when we come back, we're going to get into our first segment of Let's Talk About It. So we'll be right back, y'all. Tell a friend to tune on in.
Let's get it in, man. It's the party before the party. Mr. Party himself is back all over the world. Let's go. B, what's up? Check in with us right now. Make sure you share this on social media. You already know how I do it, man. It just takes on.
Don't you know?
getting right into it. We getting right into it. Hey, it's the party before the party. It's Party Mode Live. I'm your man, DJ D Money. That is the captain of this vessel, the beautiful Miss Justice J. Woo! I had to shake the cobwebs off with that, but I'm getting it in there.
My laptop is over here acting a fool. It's trying to reset on me in the middle of the show right now. Like, what in the world is going on? Welcome back. We are Party Mode Live, the party before the party, powered by PartyModeLive.com, GoGoRadio TV. I am your girl, Miss Justice J. And this is DJ D Money. For those of you who do not know who DJ D Money is, he was a DJ on the show before, and he is no stranger to Party Mode Live. He is family, y'all. So welcome him the same way that y'all welcome us each and every Wednesday, right here from 8 to 10 on PartyModeLive.com, GoGoRadio TV, and on our Party Mode Live Twitch and YouTube channels. But like I told you guys, we do have a special guest that is coming on tonight, and we have a lot of them. So we're going to have to get through these, like, woo, because one, we're not going to try to give y'all too much, because we need y'all to come out this Saturday to Emery Heights Community Day. And before we bring our first guest on, though, I want to say this. DJ Z Money, it's been a while since you have been up here to do Community Heights Day, Forever Emery. How does it feel for you to be back?
Oh, I'm it's been what? Like, I think I missed 1 year last year, but I am looking forward to it. As you know, I'm a kid from up top, born and raised, you know what I'm saying, uptown. So Emery Heights is real special as far as my life growing up in D.C. There you go. There's the man. And also,
King.
You know, just the go-go history of the hill. It's amazing. So to be a part of it, again, I'm looking forward. I can't wait to touch down.
I said the same thing. Like, the hill was very pertinent to it, but you know, it's not on the hill anymore. It's on the baseball field. So it's a little different, but the party is still the same.
Oh,
the party is still the same.
Party Mode Live in the building. It's okay. You know what they say. Exactly. Through darkest day and brightest nights, we still party hard up Emery Heights. All right. I know.
But at least everybody don't have to climb up the hill, though, because that hill was treacherous. Yeah. And especially on the years that it when it rained, people going down. Oh, that was funny. That was comical for me.
Now you know I've never experienced a hill.
Really?
Yeah, you haven't. You've only been on the baseball field.
So I'm glad. Because if it's treacherous like that, I can't walk up a flight of steps. It's over.
I mean, it's only around the corner. Like, it's on the backside of the baseball field. Like, all they did, they changed the locations, but it's still that same field. Like, it's all still connected. But it's a lot better where it is now because, like I said, it's a little less dangerous.
Nice place to
walk up. Yeah. But, like I said, you guys, welcome Bishop King to the show and DJ D Money. I'm your girl, Justice J. We are going to keep things moving right along. We have our first guest of the night, Miss Janeese Lewis George. But before we bring her on, though, y'all, check out a couple of the other guests that we've had on the show in the past. And if you would like to be a guest of Party Mode Live, send us an email to partymodelive@gmail.com. But check this out. We'll be right back.
This is Wisdom Speaks.
I am Shonda Scott.
Yo, this is Since 96.
It's your boy Rodney Red Grant, and you tuned in to the party before the party, before the party, before the party.
This is Wisdom Speaks.
I am Shonda Scott.
Yo, this is Since 96.
It's your boy Rodney Red Grant, and you tuned in to the party before the party, before the party, before the party, before the party. Keep laughing at these fools.
It's gonna hurt me, I can't lie. Maybe you meet another guy. Please, darling, don't you cry. Let's just kiss and say goodbye. I am Gerald Alston, and you are tuned in to the party before the party.
This is Big Phil Speaks.
This is China Pink.
My name is Christina Abiola.
My name is George Maple.
What's up, y'all? It's your man, the B-I-G-G-R-B-B, Big Rob. And guess what, baby? You now in tune to the party before the party.
What's up, y'all? This is Princess J.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your girl, Keandra Lockett here.
I'm Terry Lomax.
Hey.
It's Taisha Marie.
What's happening? DJ Dirty Rico, the Noisemaker's my name. How the hell are you? And you're tuned into the party before the party. It's Party Mode Live, baby.
Hello. Welcome to the show. How are you, Miss Janeese?
Hi.
Hey. Welcome.
You're so stupid. Goodness, look at this. All right, so look, we're not going to waste any time. We are not going to waste any time, but welcome to Party Mode Live. We're going to jump right on in. You are a Ward 4 council member. One, tell us what that means to you to actually be a part of council for Ward 4.
That's right. I'm born and raised uptown. I'm a Kennedy Street girl. I grew up on 2nd and Kennedy. So shout out to the entire KDY. For me, being able to represent my home ward where I was born and raised just means so much to me. You know, I feel like DC has been changing, and as DC changes, we got to have people representing us that represents real DC, Black DC, Native DC, Go-Go DC, Chuck Brown DC, Backyard DC, you know, and so for me, it means everything to just be able to represent my hometown, my home ward, and really give back to the people who raised me. When I think about like Emory, I spent so much time up Emory as a child. And you know, everybody who poured into my life, you know, my grandma said, look, you got to lift as you climb and don't ever forget where you came from. So that's what I've done. I never forgot where I came from. And I'm back here to fight for young people like myself to be able to have a future in this city, and to make sure that we have a place in this city.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha. Go ahead, Bishop.
Yeah, so to do what you're doing, you actually have to have some type of love for the people. Yeah. But actually doing it for your own people, not just Black people, but this is where you're from. This is where you grew up. This is where you're born and raised. Like, how much does that mean to you?
Yeah, I mean, it is an honor. You know, it is, it feels like this is what my ancestors wanted me to do, right? With my grandma preached to me, you know, on our block, everybody raised us. Miss Am, you know, made sure I had food, made sure, you know, when I was going to college, I had stuff to go, you know, and I think about Miss Wallace next door, you know, my mom is a postal worker, she'd be working nights, you know, my community, like my block took care of us. It really was a time where it took a village to raise a child. And, you know, this is about more than just me, it's about a village, you know, and we gotta, each one teach, you know, for me, it's an honor to be able to give back to the community that gave to me and to keep the generations of this going, to be able to make sure other young people have the opportunities, the educational opportunities, the, you know, be able to, you know, buy a house in this city, to be able to live in this city, to be able to start a business in this city, to run a podcast and a radio show in this city and for our city. And so, you know, it's an honor. It's an honor. I take it as a blessing every single day. And I really give my all and my heart to this. You know, we work late nights, late days. I tell people, like, I feel like, you know, God put me on this path, on this mission, on this purpose. So, you know, I don't get tired the way other people get tired. You know, every day I wake up thinking about how can I help my community be better, and how can I help our young people see a future in this city, and a future outside of, you know, all the negative stuff we hear, but to uplift and show our young people we love them, we're going to support them, and we want to see them succeed as well.
How can the people actually help you?
Say it again.
How can the people, I know your job is to help the people, yeah, but we also got to help ourselves. So how can the people help you?
You know, I say to everyone, you know, whatever your skill, whatever your talent is, like everybody's not into politics and everybody don't have to be into politics, but what is it that you can teach your community? Like, are you some, you know, I told somebody, if you into real estate, how do you teach your community how to buy a house, how to keep generational wealth? How do you go to a grandma and say, you know, make sure you have a will before you pass away, so you pass on your housing to your children? Mm-hmm. If if you're somebody, you know, may not be in real estate, you in the art, right? And so many young people have art skills and don't know how to turn that into monetary. How do you teach young people how to use their art to be able to gain, employment, to be able to do art throughout the city, right? It's really about what is your natural talent that God has gifted with you, and how can you share that gift to our young people to help them choose a different path that may be similar. You know, if you, you know, you, if you got a DJ booth and so many kids want to do that type of work, want to be in a studio, open your studio. You know, young kids can't afford studio time like older people can. If you got a studio, give them 3 hours in the studio, let them get that energy out, you know, on the mic, right? So I say the way people can help is by using your natural gifts and talents and everything you've learned and reaching out and touching our community in that way, whatever your heart gives, you know, do that. But also pay attention, though, right? Because, you know, election time comes, everybody's like, oh, you know, everything will be all right, it's going to be okay. But it's not, you know. Our city is growing differently and more, and it is more diverse. And if we don't have people who are on the council, in our school board, on doing the work in the community, our ANC commissioners, then we're going to not see ourselves in the work that's happening and not be able to do that. So, you know, my other thing is pay attention, show up to the meetings, show up and be willing to be in leadership roles. And when you have opportunities like this one, we're doing a back to school giveaway. It is so many young people, some families who really can't afford. Look, the price of groceries up, the price of gas up, the price of everything up. It's harder than ever for parents right now to raise children and make sure they have the things they need. So that's why we're doing this giveaway, right? Free backpacks, books, school supplies to any families that need them. You know, if you have the ability to do that, to give back to your community and show up for somebody, like that's what we need. That's what we need. We need more people showing up and reaching out and not being afraid. You walk on the street, new neighbors, sometimes they don't speak. I have to go up to everybody's door. Hi, how are you? How you doing? What's your name? Okay, what you do? Like, okay, great. Well, let's connect. How do we connect? You know, so people got to stop being so, you know, in their silos and thinking everything good and step out and
right.
And reap and pull and talk to not only our young people, but also our seniors. You know how many seniors I know who, you know, I go knock on their door, I go in their kitchen sometimes and they don't got nothing in the refrigerator. No food in the refrigerator. Our seniors, you know what I mean? So we got to get out of the space where we are, you know, so, you know, focused on ourselves and really like reach back to community and give back in the way that you can with the talents and the gain, you know, through life and through your career.
Wow. Sweet.
Did you need money?
I'm a War 4 kid too. I grew up more towards the Petworth side of Georgia Avenue. Just real quick, did you go to Rose or did you go to Coolidge?
I went to Walls.
I just messed with you.
I went to school without Walls. My sister went to Rose. I went to Rudolph.
Okay.
Yeah,
shout I went out to your sister, Rough Rider for Life.
Yeah, my sister, Rough Rider.
You talked about the community and giving back and bringing that family thing. One thing that I always wanted to know, they took Georgia Avenue Day away, which was real big in World War IV, especially from the top of the hill to the bottom of the hill. And Emory Heights was like the kickoff, the center part of it. What would it take for us to get to you to back you up as far as bringing that back uptown?
Yeah, so I've been talking about trying to bring Georgia Avenue Day back uptown. So apparently the last Georgia Avenue Day ended up costing the city a whole bunch of money. I don't know all the drama behind it, but essentially the very last Georgia Avenue Day, apparently there was like an outstanding bill that was not paid to this new day. It's just getting the community and asking the mayor, like, you look, we do this, the city does this funding for, you know, for open streets. Can we do the same thing for Georgia Avenue Day, which is more of a cultural celebration, a community day versus just focusing on, you know, the traffic safety and things of that nature that's supposed to be open streets.
Okay. You enlightened me because I always wanted to know. It had to be something else.
Yeah, it was some drama.
I ain't want to go there.
Yeah, it was some drama that went down back in the day. I don't know. I was a child, but everybody was like, yeah, they left the city with a large bill. I'm like, okay, well, that's the past. Let's move forward and make it work.
We got to get our little midget friend with the dreads in the South Side to get us a South Side Day because all this uptown talk, man. I swear.
I went to Union Temple in Southeast, so I don't know. Unifact. Unifest used to be out in Southeast.
Yeah. Little Midget friend, if you're listening, awesome. We need one. Yeah.
You remember Unifest?
I'm not that old, but Justice, you might have been there.
I was about to say, you definitely remember that, Bishop. You can't say I remember, Bishop. One, I ain't even from D.C., sir. I'm a Maryland Bama, so that's you. No,
even Maryland people was at the Unifest, man. Even Maryland people was at the Unifest.
I remember when I was a child, Dusty's child was at Unifest. Beyonce was at Unifest.
Everybody was at the Unifest.
During Unifest, during those times, though, that era, I was a church girl. So back I knew nothing about Unifest. I knew nothing about Unifest, so. I've only heard stories about it. I've never been to one. I don't even like, other than hearing like some people telling me what it was, I've never been to one. So I don't know. I was a big girl growing up.
It was
but look, so this Saturday though, Forever Emory Community Heights Day. You guys, you said you're doing a giveaway for the kids for back to school. I know years before, there we go. Live music, fitness, wrestling. They're doing a giveaway. Friends of Emory Nonprofit 501c3. Councilmember Miss Janeese Lewis George, who is on the show right now, you guys. They're doing a back to school supply giveaway. So bring the kids. What does this mean to you to be able to actually give school supplies? Just because I know a lot of people are doing back to school supply giveaways and everything. And one of the things that I have heard a lot of parents talk about, mainly the people who are donors, is you have families that jump from giveaway to giveaway to giveaway to giveaway. Is there a limit on how many supplies a family can obtain?
I mean, it's based on each child. So, you know, every child gets a bag full of supplies. You know, different organizations in the you know, wards and the churches do it as well. But it's going to be while supplies last. So I keep telling everybody it's from 12 to 8, but get there early because, you know, they go fast. They go quick. Coach Lou is really great. I don't know. Everybody knows Coach Lou. So we're proud to be partnering with Coach Lou, who does an amazing job mentoring and our young people and building relationships. He coaches the football team, you know, all of those things. So Coach Lou always has a number of backpacks. Then our team, we bring in school supplies. So we're partnered with everybody. Brett and Tiffany Green from Walmart were throwing in. Safeway has thrown in. So we're hoping to have a lot of supplies. We got some amazing partners coming together to put these together. So, but it is as supply while supplies last. So get there early, please, on Saturday, starting at 12 o'clock.
Have you guys ever thought about doing like a mid-year school supply giveaway? Just because, you know, them supplies don't last the whole year. Not to say that the parents shouldn't be, you know, purchasing things on their own, but I've never seen it done. So, you know, just to throw that out there.
No, I think it's a good idea to do that. We try to do like the coat drives too, starting in October, November. Because there's a lot of kids who don't have, you know, the coats, the hats, scarves, all of that costs too. So we try to do that as well. And then hygiene products is a big thing now. You know, those costs. So we try to do hygiene products, you know, your deodorant, lotion, stuff like that, as giveaways, because that's another need that we hear from parents and families too. But yeah, we should absolutely do school supplies throughout the year, because after that first semester, you know, by the time they're gone and they didn't beat up everything, got holes in the bag because they didn't done everything they can in the bag, throw it all over the place. So yeah, for sure. Actually, we should partner. Look, you know me, I'm always looking forward to it. We should partner and do something in December, January.
Partymode Live would love to. We would love to. We love doing the giveaways. We love doing everything. So we usually do the turkey giveaway as well with Emory. So, you know, we're a part of all of that. So we would love to. But if anyone would like to donate, how can they connect with you to be able to donate supplies or volunteer for Saturday?
Yeah, you can reach out to my team. You can, I'm on Twitter and Instagram at Janeese4DC. You can always, on Friday, we will be stuffing bags at Emory Recreation. We're going to be doing all the bag stuffing. Coach Lou will be there. So you can always reach out to Coach Lou and the friends at Emory. So we'll be there Friday evening stuffing the bags for Saturday. So you can stop by Friday if you have items that you want to donate, and we can assign you to a volunteer shift for Saturday.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. So it has definitely been a pleasure of having you on Party Mode Live. We are looking forward to seeing you and meeting you on Saturday. I don't know if the other two guys on the show have met you before, but I'm looking forward to meeting you Saturday.
That's right. I love it. Justice J, I'm excited to meet you. Of course, Bishop King and DJ Money, I'm really excited. Justice J, look, everybody in my family is a J. So my dad named all his kids J names. So in his house, it'd be like, J, it's fine. Yep. So you family. And you just, you're in a J family right now.
Well, you're Party Mode Live family now, so you're stuck with us for life. But before we let you go, there's something that we need you to do. You're going to introduce yourself, and then you're going to say you're tuned into Party Mode Live, the party before the party.
Oh, Lord. Okay. I'm ready. I just say my name.
You can say I am Janeese Lewis of Ward 4, whatever, or whatever, however you want to introduce yourself. And then you're tuned in to Party Mode Live, the party before the party.
All right. It's Janeese Lewis George, Ward 4 council member, and you are tuned in to Party Mode, the party before the party.
Yes. Okay, Wente. Let's get it. Once again, thank you so much. We will see you Saturday. Make sure you guys come on out this Saturday to Emery Heights Community Day. Y'all don't want to miss it for the back to school giveaway. We have live entertainment, live bands, go-go fitness, live wrestling, and y'all are going to get to meet some of those people today as well. So don't go nowhere. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Y'all are still tuned in to Party Mode Live, the party before the party. Powered by PartyModeLive.com, GoGo Radio TV, Justice J, Bishop King, DJ D Money, and Miss Janeese Lewis George of Ward 4. Y'all, we'll be right back. DJ D Money, you ready to crank out a little bit?
Let's do it.
Let's get it.
Oh, my Southside crew, what's up, Bishop?
It's a story about the junkyard band that started 4 years ago. We were playing in the alley, cause in Southeast Berry Park, Southeast Berry Park, the junkyard band started moving up. The hard work paid off. Laughing and playing with the manager, Mr. Dirk O'Gray, Mr. Dirk O'Gray. The public started loving it. We were finally getting our props. We're now sitting in D.C. camp. Also Cavaliers, also Cavaliers. We'll go, go, bus. That's me, y'all, folks, the wink. Now, Tricky Ray.
Let us know where y'all are listening in from. Let us know what y'all sipping on. Loose. We'll be right back though with C3W and our first Let's Talk About It.
And Huff and
let's get it for the South Side right now. Yo, my Huntsville, Alabama crew checking in. What's up? DJ D Money got his big red cup action. I ain't got a party bucket, but I got the big red cup, baby.
You had a party bucket on Saturday. Don't worry about it. Got a time to sip on some Buffet tonight.
For sure, for sure.
Miss Tracy.
Y'all ain't heard this one in a long time. You know what I'm talking about? money. All gas, no brakes.
Again, man, it is the party before the party. It's your man DJ D Money on the spinners. Shout out to my man DJ Rick doing his thing right now. Just holding it down for him, you know what I'm saying? I'ma keep it south side for you. I'ma keep it south side for you. To the legendary James Funk, he just set it a P-Day. All the Leos, you know what I'm talking about.
Let's go.
shock my man. Let me shock my co-host one time, Justin.
Let's do it. Come on. Listen. Pretty girl, you smile at me. I kiss your lip. That's why I hold you tight. You wink at me. I called you. And you came to me. That's why I love you so. You called me. I answered. You treat me.
That's the guy with the good talk on his stuff. I thought I was doing my homework.
Now, ain't that a blip?
It's under mine because he got my name, so all that money coming to me anyway. Good looking, though.
You should king a gangster rap.
But listen, y'all. Y'all are tuning in to Party Mode Live, baby. We are the Party Mode. Party Mode Live. Party Mode Live. Party Mode Live. Party Mode Live. Justin J, Mr. King, and DJ D. Money. Hey, money. So listen, y'all. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about it. And y'all already know what I want to talk about.
Let's go.
We can't hear the memo.
There we go. Money, we back in the show. We back in the show. This is our Let's Talk About It, y'all. And y'all already know what I want to talk about. But I want to talk about it from a different perspective because a lot of people have only been looking at it from one point of view. So I want to know if y'all still feel the same way about this Alabama brawl. Like, one, everybody knows, you know, when the hat comes off, it's on and popping. Like, that's the new bat signal. Everybody now already established that, right? When that hat come off. But there is another angle of a video that has come out that captured the entire thing from beginning
to the end.
And it turns out that our so-called hero, what they're trying to say is that he was in the wrong because he was actually a co-captain on the boat that was trying to park. Was trying to dock, and he decided to go up there to move the boat. So we still know that to be correct, but he wasn't even the security guard. He was the co-captain of that big ferry thing and went over there and decided to, you know, take matters into his own hands. But I still believe, and I want to know if y'all still believe, I still believe that he was not wrong. Because if there are people that are designated there to actually, you know, secure the dock and make sure people are actually docking in the right spot, then the security members failed to do their job to make sure that those people did not park in that spot where that boat was supposed to be parked at. So I'm still ain't mad at it. So what y'all feel?
But there you have it. There's people in place to make sure that this does not happen, and they have failed to do their job. He is not one of those people.
Mm-hmm.
And he still have a uniform on, and he's representing the company that he is working for. But he stepped over the line.
He did.
And it was no coming back once the white guy put his hands on. But your job is going to say if you never cross that line, hell, if your black ass didn't get off that boat, we wouldn't even be here right now. But you did, and then this would happen. So he probably get blamed for the entire ordeal because he shouldn't have did what he did. But defending himself, I mean, body language says a lot. I don't know what was said. I know what was said from the people that was recording. They was all with it. They didn't care. But I don't know what was said between the two. It looked like a heated conversation. It looked like my man was saying, nigga, I've been at work for 12 goddamn hours. It's hot as hell out there, and y'all in the way. I got something to do. And you know what I mean? The white dude was basically saying, I'm not moving shit, pal. And then he took the hat off and out the, you know, all of that. It just caused, if it didn't cause a big scene or a big melee, I don't think it would have been much of a big deal. But because of what transpired afterwards, it's going to be like you had our uniform on, you was representing the company, which is supposed to be professional at all times. Like, you got to understand, I was always taught that you are being paid to be professional, these other people not. So who cares what they do, right? Or whatever they say. I'm sure you've been cussed out on that boat plenty of time. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So that's the only way I think that he was wrong, because he was representing the company. But defending himself, I don't think he was wrong for that.
What's your thoughts, Manny?
Well, I look at it.
Turn your volume up.
Oh, okay, okay. Is that better? Okay.
There we go.
I didn't. Well, this is news. I seen a lot of the angles, but I didn't get any info. Like you just dropped that he was a co-captain or working on the other ship. Now, with that being said, until we kind of, I guess we'll never know how did. Like you said, how did he deliver, hey, can you move your boat? I'm trying to park. Because clearly on those docks, those ferries have priority parking spaces to load and unload. So even if he went up there and said it being a worker on the ferry boat, it wasn't his job, but he had the position to say, dude, you know you ain't supposed to put your boat right there.
That's the thing. No one was present to move the boat. He decided to do it himself, and they came walking up and saw him moving the boat himself.
Oh, he went on them people's boat.
He undocked. Let's back it up
just a little bit. So before he unraveled the rope and everything, he went over to the dock security and asked them, you know, where the people are that own this boat. I need y'all to get these people that move the boat. They failed to do so. So he decided that he was going to take matters into his own hands, because here I am with a ferry full of people and I'm on a time schedule.
And a parking lot of people waiting to get on.
Man, full of black people yelling, move, bitch, get out the way.
No, it wasn't black people. It was a white person that actually recorded this one. It was white people on there too, but they were all in agreement that the people were wrong, though. The amount of white people that are actually coming out and they're agreeing with what the captain did, though, because they're all saying, like, it's a whole bunch of white people that are saying, well, y'all already know how we get when we out on our boat, we get drunk and we get, you know,
right
out of there. And so they're like, you know, dude was wrong. And he had to do what he had to do to get make sure those people got off safely and were on time, because he had another round of people that he had to get up on that ferry. So I don't think he was wrong. I think he should have gotten, you know, the next level of people involved before, you know, moving them people boat, because what if something would have happened to their boat? Then you'd be responsible for that as well.
And also you got to remember, like, if we are walking up, and we probably twisted, and we walking up from having a good time, me, you, and Money, we walking up, and somebody moving our boat, we gonna go ham.
We gonna go off, because we don't know who you are.
For sure.
But they didn't go ham right away. Something was said for that dude to turn back, because they walked back and forth past him without even looking at him plenty of times in the video, until he started going off a little bit more.
That scenario.
Dude was basically saying, you know what, I'm sick of your mouth. And he went off. But
I think one of them people turned around and walked away and said, nigga, I wish you could. But he didn't say I think he said the other one. And that's when the hat was just like, what a worry. Cool. That's what I think.
Jim, get him on the show, because I really want to know why he threw his head up.
And they were pumped up because President Trump had just did a rally down there. So them good old boys was pumped up anyway.
Hey, man, we want you, pal.
Let me put my accent on. A lot of things played a lot of things and a lot of factors in this one there, boy. And I think that they knew that, you know, in their mind, they could do whatever it is that they wanted to do. And that man came over there and said, not today. You're going to fuck around and find out. Then let's find out. And that's
it. I say a lot of good was done, a lot of wrong was done. I don't think nobody deserved to go to jail. A lot of people got locked up, but I mean, you know, a fight is a fight, and it blew out of proportion, so somebody had to get locked up. I hope they just was in the tank cooling off and they let them out, you know what I mean? But
speaking of wrestling and everything, you know, we gonna bring on our good homies of C3W. I'm really excited to have them on the show because what I want to know from a wrestler's standpoint, you know, what you would have did in that situation. Like, I really want to know.
That's a good one.
And they got you, and they had you. And now it's a
big chairs
everywhere.
They had a live wrestling match.
They had a lot of props.
Like, that's what I thought.
Everybody, like, if you see this, you know what this be. They got the chair in their hand. Like, oh, man.
The tower put a power too sweet to be sour, funky like a monkey, space is the place, the sky's the prize, and breaking backs is what I do. I am G Postal, and Lord knows I would have been ready to fight all.
Wow.
Listen.
You would have been the one diving in the water, swimming over.
Hey, I'm like this. I don't do water unless I'm at the pool, Jack. I tell you like it is. I'll be tossing people into the water, if you know what I mean. Just like an over-the-top rope battle royal, there'll be people down the wind. You're going to have to call the Navy to go save them.
So I hope y'all going to incorporate this whole thing into Saturday somehow. Because that's going to be pure comedy. But if you were there, though, how different would that it would have been? Oh, my God.
I mean, also remember, it looked like a race war, and it was in Alabama. I mean, there you go. That's why they jumped
all
in.
All places in the South, boy. They picked Montgomery.
I honestly feel like even though it was so small, it was a big statement.
And like, then they picked the old slave trade.
It was a big statement. I don't know.
Did y'all know that was a part of history?
No, I didn't. And I don't know if
the dock where this whole thing took place was actually part of the slave trade where slaves were actually brought and sold.
Now, so we need to go to the Woodrow Wilson Bridge and fight every... Never mind.
So, okay. Wow. Anyway, C3W is coming to Emery Heights Community Day. What can we expect from you guys this year?
Well, I'll go first. First of all, thanks for having us up here. I'm going to introduce myself. My name is Richie Fingers. I'm the CEO of Capital Combat Championship Wrestling, a.k.a. C3W. We are the fastest growing professional wrestling brand in the world today. You can find us on Instagram at C3 Wrestling. And you can also find our website, www.c3wrestling.com. And for me, it's an honor to do Emery Heights because I'm from uptown. You know what I'm saying? But see, I've been in different capacities at Emery Heights. You know what I'm saying? I played sports growing up. But I also, like my first musical experiences, like my man was talking about with Georgia Avenue Day. You know what I'm saying? Like, I remember when, like, the bands was playing at the bottom of the hill closer to Georgia Avenue, you know what I'm saying? Like, that was way back in, like, the 80s, like, the late 80s, you know? So
by the gas station in the corner.
Down that way. You already know what I'm talking about, you know what I'm saying? So, like, I saw EU Hot Cold Sweat, and I was, like, a little kid. Like, that was my first experience. Like, I got to be in the – so, you know, I played in the Go-Go, you know, Go-Go Circuit for a while. I even played at the top of the hill, you know what I'm saying? So now be able to do a wrestling match, you know what I'm saying, come from a whole nother angle. You know, number one, I'm letting people know, like, whatever's in your heart, you know, go chase it. You don't find too many people that's going to say, man, I'm going to start a pro wrestling league. And so, you know, me and Casino Hayes, we say, hey, man, let's do wrestling. You know, everybody a musician, everybody a rapper, you know what I'm saying? You know, everybody in the band. You know, this is a whole another production, you know what I'm saying? If you're a producer, if you're athletic, you know what I'm saying? If you're like an actor or all that, in one, that's the quickest way to the entertainment industry. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I'm on it. So I know G Post probably got a few words, but.
Hey, 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 I'm the one and only G Post, the madman from Postal Land and the brother with the guns. That'll take down the sun, Jack. I'm going to try to tell you, this is going to be exciting. It's going to be fun. I can't wait. Emory Heights Day, this is round two. And C3W is going to blow the roof off the sky. It's plain and simple, man. Like I said, I'm looking forward to Emory Heights. I'm probably from the other side of town or whatnot, over in Eastover or whatnot. That's where I grew up at. But I ain't got nothing but love. I've also been the mailman up and down Georgia Avenue. So that's like home for me up there in Emory Heights.
You know exactly where you're going there. All the zip
code. Yeah, man. I'm talking about all the way from the dollhouse all the way up to McCumbo's and all the way to the Walmart and Rittenhouse and back again, if you know what I mean, Jack.
Whose house?
Oh, you know exactly where I'm coming from. Off the top row with it. The dollhouse. I know. See, I know you've been to the dollhouse. No judgment. Some good looking ladies in there. Been there, done that.
If anybody listening and you agree and your wife heard it, he said egg rolls and mumbo sauce. He didn't say dollhouse and McCombo. He didn't say that. He said two-piece combos. Don't get that man in trouble, man.
Yeah, Popeye's right across the street.
Right across the street, too. Next to the dealership. Anyway, yeah.
He said he played with a go-go band up top. What band did you play with back in the day?
The last band I played with was Wisdom Speak. But okay. Shoot, I done played with so many different groups, man. Like, I've been out here. I'm a musician too, so you know, and that's the other thing. You know, I try to tell people, like, if you have like most of us, like Justin Jay, you a singer, right? But deep down, yeah. You probably got a whole bunch of other things that you want to do. You know what I'm saying? I tell people, man, do all that. You know what I'm saying? You can sing right here, turn around, sell some t-shirts on the backside. Turn around and do a movie, like, man, don't go for it. That's all we doing, you know what I'm saying?
But Rich, you said wrestling was the quickest way as far as entertainment. But right. I know that's not what you was thinking when you said wrestling. Let's just do wrestling. Made you say let's go with wrestling.
Because wrestling is the quickest way to the entertainment industry. It's a $1 billion industry. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't forget, it's a $1 billion industry. So imagine going after 3% of that. You hear what I'm saying?
I tell you, like I say, wrestling is the greatest combination of athleticism as well as having a personality so big and so large that people come looking for you. It ain't about what the WWE or anybody else does or whatnot. They may have things where guys have gimmicks, but I tell people like this, if you ain't giving them the real in you or whatnot with professional wrestling has to be organic. It has to be organic on a microphone, has to be organic in the wrestling ring or whatnot. And that's what takes, well, that's the difference between professional wrestling and sports entertainment. But the thing about it is the personality that you have, you turn it up all the way to the high denominator or whatnot, and you show people what's special about you, and that's when they come in to see you. That's when they're knocking down the doors. Matter of fact, Emory Heights is special to me because I'm supposed to be in Delaware doing a movie premiere, but I'm coming to see you guys or whatnot. I'm coming there to wrestle. I'm coming there to just break backs and count up some money stacks. So y'all better get ready.
Real quick, I want to say. Think about who's one of the biggest movie stars right now. The Rock.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? Outside of that, who's doing more TV shows? John Cena.
Oh, that
name
wasn't
the first
name that came to mind when you said that.
But we're in the space of wrestling right now, so you know what I'm saying.
Okay. You mean wrestlers? Okay.
Yeah, but what I'm saying, but he's like a whole big deal. Through wrestling, he became like a super billionaire. Most people that when they walk through WWE halls, you know, they spin away and end up doing big stuff. So we're developing C3W, that same platform, you know what I'm saying? Like, we have our own wrestling school. I'm also a personal trainer. So
yes, sir.
You know, like anybody out there that's looking to become a professional wrestler, like, we get you there, we get you right, you know. And once you get started, I mean, you'll see how fast you'll make it.
They walking around suits and they as big as one. I'm just saying, y'all better go ahead and get in that ring, ladies. I mean, whoever listening who want to do this.
Hey, they definitely females, you know what I'm saying? So,
Who are some of the wrestlers we can look forward to seeing on Saturday?
I'm sorry?
Who are some of the wrestlers we can look forward to seeing on Saturday? What are some of the matches?
Well, I can't really let you know too much about that just yet, but what I can say is a lot of them are local. You know what I'm saying? So it'll be a treat for you guys and for them, you know what I mean? Where, you know, like a lot of these guys, they travel like the East Coast around the world. So a lot of them never get a chance to wrestle home. So this is going to be big for them.
Nice. So we'll have our champion out there,
Mr. Grimm. That's our C3W heavyweight champion. He'll be out there, the Hitman for Hire. He posted going to be there. He's our commentator. But it seems like every time we have a match, while he's on commentary, somebody's going to mess with him. Hoping that this week won't nobody mess with him and just allow him to, you know, be the commentator. So, our other family voice, what's his name, Aaron. He'll be there. The pharmacist,
Mr. Guy. What you need, baby?
We also going to have special guest referee. DJ Rico is going to be a ref and Lisa of the World. And Lisa of the World, if you hear me, hey, hit me on the DM because we want to pull her deep in the wrestling. You know what I'm saying? I know she's a super fan, so you know we can put her on the platform right here. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, she would love that. She would definitely love that. She says she's waiting for her specialized, customized referee shirt on Saturday too. So,
all right, tell her. Hey, if you hear me, DM me. I got you.
So the main event, though, you guys have a main event. How many fights can we actually look forward to leading up to the main event on Saturday? Or are you guys going to try to get as many as you can?
Well, tentatively, we're going to do two matches every hour, but that may change. We're going up until, I think, 5 or 6. I could be wrong. That subject will change, but right now, that's tentatively. I want to say two matches in between the bands. You know what I'm saying? The band stuff. But again, I'm not totally sure yet. So basically, what I'm trying to say, y'all,
is y'all just got to be there between the hours of 12 and 9 o'clock on Saturday. Exactly. So that way y'all don't miss anything, because we're going to have live wrestling the entire day, along with the bands and vendors and go-go fitness and everything else. The back-to-school giveaway, everything. So y'all don't miss nothing. Just be there.
So for the kids, we're going to do an entrance contest. So we allow the kids, you know, to come to the ring. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, they can imitate, like, they Triple H or somebody. You know, so, aww, you know, so we're going to have, you know, we definitely have that. We're going to also do, like, the whoever got the best pose, you know what I'm saying? So it's going to definitely be interactive between the, you know, the community and, you know, and the wrestling. Because the thing is, especially in Washington, D.C. doesn't get, I'll call it grassroots wrestling all like that. And that's one of the things that we bring here. But if you go to any other town, like Philadelphia, New York, Chicago, most towns have this. Like, that's part of their culture. And we're bringing CPW to make that, you know, to add that in the culture with the, you know, with go-go, with hip hop, with everything else that DMV has to offer.
Looking forward to Saturday. Either of y'all got a question?
Money.
No. Come on, guys. I know y'all got a question. Come on, give me something, guys. Come on, give me something.
Hey, tell them what's happening this weekend, dog. Go ahead, close it out.
This Saturday night, it goes down 5801 Georgia Avenue. Lightning bolts, thunderstorms is coming, heading your way. We're getting ready to not only blow the roof off the sky, we're going to have the go-go bands jumping, we're going to have the kids jumping, telling their mama, I need to get down to ringside to see some C3W wrestling, showcasing why we are the very best in professional wrestling. There is the new gold standard in wrestling, and that's C3W. And I tell you what, folks, there's going to be backs cracking, there's going to be livers quivering, there's going to be septums deviated and rectums kicked in come Saturday. We're going to call this Summer Madness.
Rich, how do you feed everybody on the roster as far as getting a shine on? Because if everybody is like this, how do everybody get their shine?
Hey, man, only the best of the best, dog. You know what I'm saying? That's that simple. You know, you hear how he go, everybody else go like him. So,
This is professional wrestling. You get in where you fit in. That's it. Point blank, period.
Point blank. Look, you don't get a participation trophy with this. You know what I'm saying?
I know. That's right.
Boys and girls.
Have you ever had a match that you thought you won, but you really lost?
I beg your pardon?
I was asking, have you ever had a match that at the end you felt that you won, but you ended up taking an L on?
Yeah, plenty of times. Guys hit me with low blows. I referee act like he don't see it blatantly. I mean, I've been through so many things. I've wrestled up and down the East Coast, man. You would not believe the craziness I've been through. But any fair fight, G Postal has come out on top. I deliver the pain wherever I go. I will rain the pain, Jack. When you got 21-inch guns like these, Jack, this ain't set for fun, man. It's for breaking backs.
Mm.
Listen,
ladies, come on out and see him break a couple of backs.
G Post, I need you to, before the match, I need you to pull up at 732 Chesapeake Street. Whoever answers the door, you get them.
As long as you have a check on my, as long as you got the check. That's all right, with my name on it, with plenty of zeros behind whatever number you want to put up there, then we can talk business.
Don't pay him no mind. So anyway, we are looking forward to seeing you guys once again this Saturday at Emery Heights. What time do you guys, are you guys starting at 12 or you guys want to be starting?
1 o'clock.
1 o'clock. All right, y'all. Make sure you guys are there for your first match at 1 o'clock. We cannot wait to see you guys. Like I said, they're doing a lot of competitions, interactive things for the kids. So bring the kids on out, you guys. Mm-hmm. Wrestling is not just, you know, what you see or what you thought it used to be. This is, like you said, the number one professional wrestling out here, y'all. So come on out and witness it for yourself live this Saturday at Emery Heights Community Day. We can't wait to see y'all there. So, anything else y'all want to give us? Give us the website and your social media one more time.
All right, before I go to the website, shout out to Casino Hayes. That's my business partner and the president. He's relatives with Henry Hayes that connected all of this. So, you know, it's all one big circle of love, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to him. Shout out to DJ Quicksilver. That's our other partner right there. So, you know, y'all going to be saying some big things. All I'm going to say is be on the lookout, you know, C3W or somebody TV screen. But anyway, yeah, you can go to www.c3wrestling.com if you want to see our matches. We're on YouTube. Catch us on IG. That's our hub right there, IG, at C3 Wrestling. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, once again, my name is Richard Fingers. I'm the CEO. That's G Postman. Hey, man, come on out Saturday, man. Uptown, you know what I'm saying? It's going to be fun, you know? Bring your kids. Matter of fact, bring your kids. I know most of y'all grandparents used to watch wrestling when y'all was kids. You know, bring the family. You know what I mean? We can just have a good old time. It's a vibe. It's a mean vibe. It's a vibe, you know?
Yeah. Check this out. I'm going to give y'all a little history lesson real quick. Y'all ever heard of Capital Wrestling Corporation?
I think so, yeah.
I feel like I have, but didn't know that I did.
Yeah, the WWE, the WWF started right here in Washington, D.C. So D.C. is a wrestling town.
That's perfect.
Really?
Yes, indeed. And now the new mascot. Yeah, this started back in the 60s. It used to run up 14th Street back in the 60s, Monday nights. They used to run wrestling up there. It would run from here all the way to New York and back again.
Wow. I thought it started in Connecticut.
No, sir. It started right here in Washington, D.C., Capital Wrestling Corporation on the Dumont Network.
Hmm. All right. A little dropping knowledge. That's what we do.
Taught us.
So D.C. is a wrestling town.
So we more than just Goldberg the wrestling, huh?
Come on. We are so much more. So much more. But C3W, that's the new mascot of all great wrestling.
That's what's up.
Before we let you go, though, y'all know what y'all got to do. Y'all got to introduce yourselves, tell us who you are, and then let everybody know you're tuned into Party Mode Live, the party before the party.
Go ahead, Post. You got that. My Post is going to tear it down, big dog.
This is the one and only G Postal, and this is Party Mode Live. One more time.
Yes. You live, big dog. Come on, man.
I didn't get that I was feeling when you first got on. So I need to retake.
Come on, man. Live, big dog. Live, man. Like you in the ring.
Words, one more again.
It's the one and only G Postal, and I am with Party Mode Live, the party before the party, and nobody parties better than Party Mode Live.
Okay, yeah. I'll take that. Rich, you're not gonna do one.
My name is Richard Fingers. I'm the CEO of Capital Combat Championship Wrestling, aka C3W. And I'm here with Party Mode Live, where they get the party going all the time live.
I'll take that.
Oh, you ain't like that? Let me do it again. It was weak.
Nope. I'm going to take that because what's going to happen is y'all going to do one on Saturday, and that's the real one we're going to keep.
There we go.
Miss everything that we are bringing to y'all this Saturday from 12 to 9 p.m. Y'all don't miss this Saturday. We'll see y'all then. DJ D Money, you ready to crank up some music?
Let's do a little something.
I want y'all to make some noise, kiddy yo. One more time.
Welcome to Washington, D.C. We call it the DMV, stands for D.C., Maryland, and Virginia. We might as well do it for the Godfather, Go-Go, rest in peace, the late, great Chuck Brown.
I want to start off easy. You're so breezy.
This Saturday, Emory Heights, all the way up top, Georgia and Missouri Avenue. You'll see it. Let's go.
Thank you so much for coming out tonight. Tell you nothing but the truth. You're looking out of sight. Want you to hold what you got. This is your spot. Do it like you want it because we love you a lot. Why you shout going out to all the lovely young ladies? And we got some dynamite horn players up here. We're going to let them warm up for you in a minute. You ready?
Shout out Douglasville, ATL side. My girl Lisa from Landover, she checking in. Every Wednesday, this is how we get down. Each and every Wednesday, this is how it goes down. Slide it uptown style.
I wanna rock your world. Let's go, Trey.
Right here, man. They got my attention how they doing this. They got my attention how they doing this.
Remember the way we
Welcome to Washington, D.C. We call it the DMV. Stands for D.C., Maryland, and Virginia. This is Party Mode Live, Wednesday night, hump day. You are listening to the official sounds of Washington, D.C. called Go-Go Music. You know what I'm talking about. Let it ride a little bit. Let it ride a little bit. Take any song and make it ours. We'll take any song and make it ours. You know what I'm talking about? This was a DC favorite too, y'all. Let's go.
Hello. It's me. I was wondering if after all these years you like
me. This Party Mode Live. I need that other gear, sweet thing. To talk about it is Embry Heights. It's an uptown show. It's your man DJ D Money Justice. Keep me going, cause you know if I get in the groove, we going past 10 o'clock tonight.
So we can go past 10 o'clock just by like a minute or two, but we got to get through the interviews first. I want to let you crank out, but we got to get through the interviews first. So y'all, like we said, we have a lot of people that we're bringing on to the show for you tonight to introduce you guys to a couple of the people that you guys are going to meet and see on Saturday for Emory Heights Community Day. And without further ado, we are bringing on none other than Gerald of the Pump Blenders, who has been a part of Party Mode Live since the very, very, very beginning. So welcome, 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 Gerald. Take yourself off of mute, sir.
No. He said, man, come work this time.
Right. Like, I don't know how to do this.
It's her computer. It's her. How y'all doing?
Good. How are you?
Gee.
Hi.
First of all, I'd like to thank y'all for having me. I haven't seen you, Justice Hill, since what, last year? Nice to meet you, Bishop.
It hasn't been since
and
last
DJ
year.
DJ D Money, are you back or are you still out and about?
What you mean? I never went anywhere.
He's still in Atlanta.
He been MIA. I called him. But I have history with him also. A lot of history with him. When we was young, a policeman by the name of Ralph Patterson created a band called Raw Deal. So he was there, Hot Sauce from Backyard, Mark Lewis on trumpet, Noel Mason on trumpet. So, you know, it's a whole lot of Gregory Rice on our keys.
With the flow.
With the flow. They played with Let It Flow and started with Vibe. Make a long story short, the band lasted for about maybe 2-3 months till Hot Sauce went back to school and it faded and I went on back with the Pumpers. But I met them when they was with Maniac and the Soldiers. I was walking down the street minding my business and the drummer at the time was on the porch. He said, man, you play for the Pump Blenders? You Gerald? I said, yeah. He said, man, I need you to come on in this house, man. And he played these drums. He was the drummer. So I went down there and I played the drums. So when I played, everybody got all excited. And, I don't let none of that bother me or faze me or go to my head. So after that, I left. I say, nice meeting y'all guys and everything. I come up the steps. Everybody come up the steps. Man, we need to get your number, man. Call you in case we need you to sit in on the drums. So I'm glad to see you, Money. Money played with me last year, too. Well, 2 years ago down at Emory Heights.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I just wanted to get that out because I haven't seen him in a while. He family to me, so.
Always, brother, always.
So what does it mean for you, Gerald, to be doing Emory Heights since you guys have been doing it since the very beginning? Oh, you guys were the first band to do it. How important is it to you and why is it so important that you guys are part of Emory?
It's important now because of when I came back. Well, I was playing with another band I put together called The Secret Band. It wasn't Pump Blenders, but I had some members from Pump Blenders, and I ran into Lonnie Mack. And that time, I think it was Backyard, Mass Extension, and a couple other bands was playing. And so Lonnie Mack said, man, you need to don't change the name back to the Pump Blenders. But I had a few members from Pump Blenders and some members that that plays with me now, such as Brianna. So I changed it back to from The Secret to the Pump Blenders. And he started managing. So as he started managing, it was, it was great to have somebody that could take the place of Mr. Busey because I wasn't doing management. My thing was just come play the drums, be a team player like the rest of the band members. Mm-hmm. So he passed. He passed. It's been a minute since he's been gone. So now every time when we do play, we honor him and Mr. Busey, because Mr. Busey helped start it with Calvin Rolock and a few other politicians. And it's just a blessing to be able to still do it at the age that I am, for one. You know, I'm still can play at the age. You know, believe it or not, a lot of my members are not even alive. So I'm the only original member in this band. So it's a blessing. And I love it. I love the fact that I'm still can do what I do at my age. So I'm grateful and thankful and humble to that, to be still here to do this. So
yeah, that's definitely in this time frame a blessing. This don't have nothing to do with Emory Heights Day, but it's still go-go. And I always ask the older generation, the people who've been in the game a long time, when this bounce beat thing arrived on scene, how did you view it?
Oh, I loved it. Believe it or not, as I was doing what I was doing with The Secret, I met some youngins that I started letting rehearse 2 hours before The Secret rehearse. So they showed me how to play the bounce band. They taught me something that I didn't know nothing about. Because we was all pockets and sockets. And we had a few timbali grooves, but I love it. I mean, they was so happy to see that. They was like, all right, OG, bouncing. Oh, look, they was excited. So to me, it's a part of our culture, our music. You know, everything has changed, diversity, And then not only did they bounce, I done seen them play soccer and pockets, then going to that, and it's a great, to me, it's good music. I mean, I even said one time I was going to, at my age, by knowing certain youngins that I've met, start like trying to self-manage them, to set them, show them, put some of what I've done with Pump Blenders along with they are doing now with Bounce. And they appreciate about it.
Just the history that you have with GoGo and everything you just spoke upon, as far as the stories you just gave us, like, is it almost a natural feeling that you can't help but to think that your generation, not just your generation, but being in the game that long, that you had something to do with building the culture of GoGo?
Oh, yeah, a lot. Because I have, believe it or not, I have my youngest member, I mentor him. I taught him how to play the drums. He started playing keyboards and trumpets, so now he plays keyboard with me when he's back in D.C., when he's not in Texas. And it's a thing, where we supposed to teach, as Slick Daddy Rick say, teach one. Be one, teach one. So I feel that we have to teach and to keep the culture alive. Because if we don't, you know, instead of all this hate and all, well, yeah, this they feel that we don't like Bounce and Bounce don't like Go-Go, or they don't like the soccer. They don't like. It shouldn't even be about that. If we teach the ones that are really motivated and love what Go-Go is really about, it's about energy. It's about showing love. It's about entertaining, the call and response, all that. And, you know, we grew up around where the audience was really a part of our show. We brought everybody in. Like, you know, you can go anywhere and play Go-Go. And look at it, and a lot of people don't realize it's Go-Go in a lot of songs. So when they keep saying Go-Go dying, no, it's not dying. You know, it's still here. It's gonna be here. A lot of people just have to get out of the negativity of believing that this cannot go. It's gonna go worldwide if they believe something. You know, let's take the butt, you know. They was playing somewhere. Spike Lee see him, boom. Mm-hmm. But hit in the butt. So same thing about Bounce. They might have a hit song. Look, okay, just like we just heard, "Sexy Lady." Sexy Lady has a form of Bounce. So it's just like that. That's a hit record. I mean, you know, I look at the numbers and I pay attention with people liking what they feel, the feels of how bands play and what they like and stuff. You know, that's the knowledge that I grew up with, the structures and knowing how to make. It's about the party, like Party Mode Live, you know what I'm saying?
I just always feel like if you've been doing it for a long time and you're good at it, somebody is going to learn from you, take from you, and make it their own. Exactly. And like 5-10 years from now, if Justice stopped doing it or she's still doing it, I'm sure it's going to be a female singer who does what she do. You know what I mean? And a lot of people would take that as, oh, you jocking my style. But if you're that great, then somebody definitely going, you know what I mean? They're going to take from you to build whatever it is that they got, which I think is a blessing in disguise, honestly.
Exactly, it is. And Justice always been an entertainer, a person that, you know, people gravitated to. I've been knowing her for years. Every time I see her, one day she came up, hugged me. I didn't know who she was. So they say, who was that? I said, I don't know. Then I kept looking. I said, that's Justice J. But yeah, she always been a people person and an entertainer. And I love that about her.
Yeah, much man. You know, when I was teaching her how to do that, you know, I was thinking one day, you know.
I'm still in the game and people are seeing my style. So I take that, you know. One thing that I have told myself over and over and over again, imitation is the best form of flattery.
Yes.
And a lot of people have been taking from my performance style and, you know, implementing it into their own styles in performers that are in Go-Go today. So that are currently doing it. I don't take any shade by, you know, I don't take it the wrong way. I feel like you're taking from what I do because I'm great at what I do. So how do you feel about that? If you were to see another band play one of the Pump Blender songs or do something the way that Pump Blender's.
I look at it as a compliment. And I have seen some songs that we have played that I took and structured and brought back. Papa Was a Rolling Stone. We did Rio Edwards helped us reconstruct I Want You Back. That's what took us to the Capitol Center. Pump Me Up, Keith Busey came with the Frankenstein beginning. Keith Showtime Busey. So I love it because to me it's showing me that I got to be doing something right for you to want to imitate what I'm doing. And it's not even my song. But you have what you do is you. You see what I'm saying? That's you, what you projecting on stage for them to see you when you do what you do, your moves, your actions, your energy. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I love it. I mean, I even tell her, I tell Denise, I say, oh man, they playing that. I said, that's like paying homage. Like, okay. A lot of people don't know this. Marky Owens is my second cousin from Ray Essence. And sometimes we play 101 and we play Lock It. And he helped put Cat in the Hat together. So we do that not to try to play like them or to be like them, but we play in homage. Because Pump Blender had a 3.5-year run down Howard Theater with Ray Essence. before we start planning Fredericks.
DJ D Money must remember that. What you got to say, Money?
Hold on. Hey, warm it up, Marky. Hey, them days, that's the original Howard Theater.
Not original the Howard Theater.
Gentrified and, new Howard Theater.
It's also we have sat in a lot of some of the artists. We have done things, Bear, you know, the people, Bears, Breads and Boys, they have jumped on stage with a lot of the older Pumplins, the ones that's not here. And it's a blessing to have been around so long to do this. I started playing with Pumplins in 1979. This is what, 2023. So it's a long time. So now the management was given to me because he felt I was the one that could handle it. And I ain't want that. I was playing with Crossover Band. I wasn't even thinking about no management. All I wanted to do was play the drums. That was it. And then the one, like I said, when I ran into Mac, that's how it starts. So I thank him for pushing me to do some management situations.
Yeah,
rough job though. I wouldn't.
Gerald's leaving out.
Put on anybody, huh?
He's leaving out another key name that's doing his thing, and shout out to him. A lot of people, especially Southern Maryland, might have heard of the Rock Steady Project.
Oh, we talk every other day. Every other day because we grew up like family when we played in Pumplins, and we got a long history together. So we like brothers, we're like blood brothers. And yes, we talking about doing things again together because we did 3 years ago, we hooked up when he first did Rock Steady Project. So we getting ready to watch out for some shows that we connected with together to do stuff. And we talking about doing a reunion. So that's on the thing too. So
that's what's up.
So what's going on with Pumplins right now? Oh, I got a book coming out that I didn't write. That I'm gonna tell you what it is. What's that? Oh, Frederick, look at her. Look at her. She's a promoter. It's a book coming out that I've been told I'm in that I gave an interview like 2 years ago. And it's called Cranking the Sensual Guide to Go-Go Music. And Charles Stevenson, Alona Waltuszewski, or whatever her name is, Cato Hammond. And, I got a call. So when I got this call, a lot of this stuff happened during COVID and after COVID. And I didn't know that they was taking notes. I saw them, they had the little recorders. You don't pay some of that stuff no attention. So then I got the call. They said, man, we want to put everything that you told me in a book. So I'm proud. Like I say, I'm grateful. I'm grateful I'm still be here. But Emory Heights, we're going to have some fun. We're going to do what we got to do. We played three times that day. We got a backyard party. We're coming up there with Emory, and we leave there go play with Junkyard and Frederick Merlin.
Y'all sound like us. That was MAB last year. We had three shows last year. We got two this year.
See?
So yeah, it's gonna be an action packed day.
Yeah, but we must do this not just for Emory. We need to get together and find somewhere that we all can do some stuff together. We'll talk about it later. I'm going to hit you in your inbox.
Absolutely. So what are you looking forward to most? Or what can we look forward to from Pumplin this Saturday?
Oh, wow. Well, the norm, but a little bit something different because I have a new front line, except for Brianna. My Congo player, he's finally back with me. Then he played with a band. Just some all out, some fun, some, a little bit call and response, some grown and sexy, some crank, Best thing I can do is say we party. I done turned the band to a party band now. I gotta make people, I wanna see people enjoy what's happening with this go-go music. They want them to dance. I want them to smile. Mm-hmm. I want them to leave, anywhere we play and just be happy. Oh man, they gave a good show. I enjoyed it, So, it's always about, we always were taught to be entertainers, not to go out to try to show off or show out on other bands, just to give a great show and be thankful that we doing what we doing. So other than that, I'm up there partying everybody. Soon I finish the first show. I'm coming up there, and if you want me, come on stage and dance with you.
All right now. Look. You already know how we do it, Gerald. So yes, before we let you go, you got to introduce yourself and let everybody know they tuned in to Party Mode Live, the party before the party.
Okay. Hey, everybody. I'm Gerald Pumplinus Brooks, and we are here. I am here with Party Mode Live, the party before, as far as I'm concerned, after the party. We're going to keep that party moving on Saturday. So if y'all missed that, I don't know what to tell you. If you ain't there, you're square. See you when we see
you. Nice meeting you. Thank you so much, Gerald. We can't wait to see you Saturday. It's always a pleasure speaking with you, sir.
My chili in the back.
See you Saturday.
Hey, Gerald, tell Bree I need 3 minutes.
Tell Bree what?
Tell Bree I only need 5 minutes on the mic.
You want five minutes? Okay. Well, Justice, I'm going to have to talk to you about that time thing right for that, right? Look at Justice.
Uh-oh. And on that note, you're listening to the Party More Live, the party before the party.
Thank you for having me.
We'll see y'all this Saturday at Forever Emory Heights Community Day. Make sure you guys are there. We are out there from 12 to until we done. Be there all day. Bring your tents, bring your chairs, bring your coolers, bring your water, bring your positive attitude, and get ready to party with us, y'all. Yes. Pumplinus will be up there this Saturday performing live, y'all, so y'all don't want to miss that. And on that note, y'all, before we let DJ Money close us out, y'all.
Hey, Henry.
Looking at my watch, it's about that time for Bishop King to get serious for 2.5 seconds.
Every time we have this and it go over to like 9:50, I'm like, you gonna get me? All right, it got me. All right, Tom, I'm seeing a lot. It might crush some people's feelings. It might make you rethink some things. But hell, that's what I'm supposed to do, make you think about yourselves and think about the people that's around you. So we're going to call this one circle check, all right? I see a lot of people complaining about, you know what I mean, that the people that they love and the people that they rock with, basically your circle, you know what I mean? So when you are checking your circle, make sure you have nothing but positive energy around you. And the word no sometimes can be a real positive thing. You don't need no yes men around you. You don't need no yes women around you. You need positive energy, real, genuine energy. You know what I mean? I can't tell you who to hang around, who not to hang around. But if you're trying to become something, trying to go places, you want to meet people, you want to learn things, you want to teach things, you want to try some new things, hell, try some new food, you want to travel, you want to, you know what I mean, be around like-minded people. People with goals, ideas, and a plan. You know what I mean? You want to be around people who support you, who love you, who are going to fight for you, not just physically, but mentally and emotionally for you. Not just monetary-wise and financially asking, can you borrow $20 to the mob? Because now you the weak link, you know what I mean? So you have to be able to hold your own. Be around people that's going to keep you pushing and hold you accountable for everything that you do, whether it's good, bad. Somebody that's going to congratulate you and keep you moving and keep you pushing. And you got to also reciprocate that same, you know what I'm saying, that same energy. So you can't be around folks who are fearing growth or scared to grow. Somebody who don't see past their zip code or their neighborhood or their block or, you know what I mean, all the negative things that they see. You know what I mean? Make sure you're setting goals. If they're not setting goals, then what you're around them for? You can't be around people who don't have no goals, but they got all the weekend plans, all the go-go plans in the world, but they don't have nothing else to do in life but turn up, twerk, or have a good time, or let's get drunk, or let's smoke some, let's pop a pill, let's look for the hoes, like whatever. Like, we got stuff to do. We already in the hole. We got to get ourselves out the hole. So just check your circle, because all of that negativity, all it does, hanging around people with no goals, nowhere to go, you're going to breed that jealousy and that envy, and you're going to always be held back because you're going to try to please these people who don't give no fucks about you because they don't even have aspirations or goals of their own. They don't even dream. So how can you be a dreamer and all you're around is people who have a nightmare? So you got to get out that mindset and you got to get on your ass. Get on your feet and keep it moving. Because sometimes,
sometimes I end it like this. Sometimes the problem is not your friends. The problem is you thought they were your friends. So let that sink in. You heard me? Okay. Somebody owe me $20 an hour. Sometimes the problem is not your friends. The problem is you thought they were your friends.
I was listening to you to something, whatever. Nobody cares. Twitch and YouTube. Thank y'all so much for tuning in. But we're gonna let DJ D Money rock out for the rest of the show, y'all. We are so happy to have DJ D Money on with us tonight, and then he's also co-hosting with us on Saturday. So this is a very exciting week for us, y'all.
Oh yeah.
But yeah, y'all are in party mode. So hey, Money. Let's get it. Oh, yeah. Don't forget, y'all, this Friday, martinis, everybody free till 12. This Saturday, Emory Heights, Saturday from 12 to 8. I keep saying 12 to 9. It's 12 to 8, y'all. It's kid-friendly. Bring your kids. Bring your chairs. Bring your tents. Bring your cooler. Bring your positive attitude. MAB, Black Print Experience, Red Carpet Affair, Pump Blenders, Jukebox Prodigy, Rob Lowe the Rapper, C3W, DJ Rick, DJ Satchmo, DJ Zoe, DJ D Money, GoGo Radio Live with a live broadcast, and of course, GoGo Fitness, and it's all hosted by none other than us, Party Mode Live. Let's go, honey.
To my ATL mom.
And then we got a special surprise. So, this is y'all. Y'all can't tell nobody that you didn't know. We out there all day long. So come on out there, y'all. Each and every Wednesday, 8 to 10, y'all. We party on live. We party before the party. Thank you, DJ D-Money.